Assembly language tutorial part 1. So here is some basics of programming. So I assume that you do not have any prior programming experience. So it's just a way to tell the computer that hey, I want to run this instruction, like printing something or taking a user input. That's just a program. It takes an input, does something on that, and produces a certain output. There are various types of programming languages. Primarily the CPU understands machine language, but that's cumbersome and it's just deals with binary. So if we could figure out a way to know that the CPU is going to execute these instructions which are in binary, and we could develop certain words, and we have another program which takes those words and converts them into binary, that language is called assembly. Basically, you do not write the program which would eventually run in the CPU in binary. You write that using some keywords, some strings, phrases, stuff like that. And then there is another program, assembler. It takes that input and converts that into binary. At the end of the day, everything is binary which gets executed by the CPU. But still, assembly is also to some degree cumbersome. There are a lot of things to take care of. So we have high level languages like C, C++, Java. What happens is there is a software called compiler. It takes the C, C++ code, converts that into assembly code, and then takes that assembly code and converts that into binary. But the story doesn't end here. We have even more high-level languages like Ruby, like Python. Those are also, they also follow the same approach, and it has to be eventually converted to binary to be executed in the machine. So here is a kind of a what happens in the CPU. First, everything is just digital logic. Like there are currents, and current travels through semiconductors and produces some output. And in the CPU, we have something called instruction set architecture. Actually, here is where we have the definition of the machine language. Like we have 8 bits set to certain values, like 1000 and so on. So those are just states, like electrical states, which would eventually be running your program. So that's what's happening. And just on top of that, we have assembly language, which has the ability, like if you write something in strings, so the assembler takes that thing and converts that into those binary states, and then when it is loaded, when it is processed by the CPU, it is eventually converted in the state of current signals. And those are nothing but digital logic, normal transistor, logic gates, stuff like that. On top of assembly, we have C++. So here is a quick side note which you can go through. And by the way, all these slides would be available in GitHub, and also I would probably upload them in SlideShare or other places. I tend to stick to GitHub, so because it's open source and no one owns it. SlideShare, I don't know, maybe someone could delete that something. So here is the GitHub repository and all the slides you will find here as well. I will post that link in the description. We could go through that. So if it is binary, how do we deal with that? Like there are binaries, there are octals, there are hexadecimal, there are decimals which we humans tend to work with, like normal numbers, 1, 2, 3 and so on. So you don't do such things. You use a calculator, right? You do not have to remember all those hex equivalents. It will come along eventually as you program. So use a calculator. So this is just a basics of programming. It's nothing but passing instruction to the computer. The computer does something and it produces certain output. So that's all about programming. And I will see you guys in the next part. Thank you for watching.